The Challenged Athletes Foundation Triathlon Weekend, it's kicking off in less than an hour from now. And we are going to speak with some of the ambassadors from this very elite group, I will say. So we have Bob Babbitt joining us. And I've met you several times, Bob, and you alone are an inspiration. But you have a couple very special athletes with you as well. First of all, if you don't mind, introduce your fellas that are with you, and then we will get into all the details of the CAF.
I'm honored. Well, to my left is Rudy Garcia Tolson, who's five-time Paralympian in swimming. He's won actually two golds, two silvers, and a bronze in the Paralympics. He just did his fifth Paralympics, and he also is the first double above-knee amputee to finish an Ironman at Ironman Arizona back in 2009. He has been with us in the foundation since he was eight. Now he's 33.
Yep.
And then next to us, who's been with us since he was, I think he was about eight,
yep.
Roderick Sewell, who's also a double above knee amputee. And Roderick is a Paralympic hopeful in both swimming and in hand cycling. And he became the first in 2019, the first double above knee amputee to finish the prestigious Ironman World Championship.
That's amazing.
And again, in 2019 in Kona, Hawaii.
What, the Kona. Oh, my gosh. Okay. This is incredible stuff. Bob, I know, you know, obviously you've been spearheading this for so long. And every year it is special for us here in San Diego. We're so lucky to have these athletes come through. And I've been lucky enough to be part of a few of these teams in years past. And I can't tell you how inspiring it is. I don't know how your heart handles it all. I mean, the things we have seen these people do, it's incredible, right?
Well, absolutely. And the main deal is sport gives people hope, and sport makes you better at everything you do. I mean, Rudy's a perfect example of that. When he found sport, he was told he would never walk. He had 15 operations before he was 6 years old. He was told he would never walk. And now he's a five-time Paralympian and an Ironman finisher. And Rudy can speak to how important it is, not so much for him to achieve himself, but what he knows, how he's inspiring the next.
Yeah.
You're right. You know, this whole weekend we have athletes coming in from all over the country, a lot of first-time athletes who have never been around other athletes like themselves. So this is going to be a great opportunity for them to meet other athletes who have similar disabilities and really create lifetime friends, kind of like how I met Roderick about 15 years ago, and he was the first double amputee that I ever met. And now here we are. Many years later, still friends and actually role models for a lot of these young athletes.
You really are. Rudy, yeah. I wanted to talk to Roderick too in a second, but you started with CAF when you were 8 years old. You know, obviously, tell us how it's changed your life.
Oh, it's changed my life tremendously. You know, being a part of the Challenge Athletes Foundation since I was 8 years old really has given me the ability to go out and travel the world. Really, you know, compete in sports at the highest level at the Paralympics and Ironman, but most importantly, be an example for these young kids who can't relate to a professional football player, a basketball player, but they can relate to myself or Roderick Sewell, who are missing their limbs, missing our limbs. And, you know, we're still out here competing at the highest level and really showing everybody what's possible. And I think that's what Challenge Athletes Foundation is all about.
And that's what Rudy did for Roderick. Because Roderick had no interest in swimming. He didn't want to get wet. And seeing Rudy swimming and realizing that Rudy was going to go to the Paralympics, that led him to wanting to get swimming instruction. And don't you think that changed everything for you?
I think having that inspiration and having that example and seeing this with people and seeing that not taking no for an answer, seeing that drive and taking that on yourself and seeing what you can aspire from it. It's a ripple effect. That's pretty amazing.
Yeah, I really believe sport does give people hope, and you are proof of that. Roderick, Rudy, Bob, thank you for the incredible things you guys have done to inspire so many people. And enjoy this weekend. It's all about you guys this weekend.
Thank you so much. And thanks for your awesome support of CAF. We really appreciate it.